Next question is, prove that the co-normal points the co-normal points with respect to the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. Okay. Drawn from the point h comma k satisfy a square minus b square xy plus b square kx minus a square hy equal to 0 equation, which is also called the Aplanian. This is also called the Aplanian rectangular hyperbola, which is also called the Aplanian rectangular hyperbola. This is just for your extra information. Nobody will ask you what is an Aplanian rectangular hyperbola. So prove that the co-normal points with respect to this ellipse drawn from h comma k satisfies this equation. Please try it. Very, very simple. Alright guys, so it's very simple, should not take you more time. See, we all know that a normal drawn to x1, y1 equation is this, right? So if I'm drawing normal at x1, y1, its equation will be given by this expression, correct? And this is going to satisfy h comma k. So h comma k is going to satisfy this given equation, right? I can also say that the normal drawn from x2, y2, just keep noting it what I'm going to write. x2, y2, normal drawn from x2, y2 will be a square x by x2 minus b square y by y2 is equal to a square minus b square, correct? And just like this was, h comma k satisfied this, so h comma k will also satisfy this. Right? So guys, similarly, I can say that a square h by x3 minus b square k by y3 equal to, this equation will also be true, and a square by x4 minus b square k by y4 equal to a square minus b square will also be true. Do you see that if I have to represent a curve on which x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3 and x4, y4 lies, all I need to do is generalize this. All I need to generalize this means wherever you have your x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, x4, y4 written, I just have to replace it with x and y. Now get the feel of this. That is what JEE wants. Whether you know the art of generalizing it. So if you simplify this, dear students, you will get a square hy minus b square kx is equal to a square minus b square xy, which you can actually write it as a square minus b square xy plus b square kx minus a square hy equal to 0. And this is called the Aplanian rectangular hyperbola. Okay. Is that clear or not? Please type God level clear if it is clear. So this is one of the most difficult concepts that you may come across. You may come across. I'm saying you, it's not necessary that will always come. So now we'll talk about the concept of pair of tangents, just like the same way we did for a circle. Please remember, pair of tangents equation is t square is ss1. Okay. And if I talk about the standard form of the ellipse, you know your t is going to be x, x1 by a square, y, y1 by b square minus 1. S is going to be this expression. And s1 is going to be this expression. Okay. Moving on. Chord of contact. Let me just draw the diagram over here so that all of you can make sense. So these are the pair of tangents. Let's say you're drawing. Okay. So these are called the pair of tangents. And this line connecting the point of contact, this is called the chord of contact. This is called the chord of contact. Again, same old stuff, nothing new here. The chord of contact equation is again t equal to 0. Again, t equal to 0. So, let's take a question on this before we move on to some other concept. Question is, prove that the chord of contact of tangents drawn from the point H comma K to your standard form of the ellipse will subtend a right angle at the center if h square by a to the power 4 plus k square by b to the power 4 is equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. Okay. And hence also find the locus of h comma k. So whosoever is able to do it will get a samosa from me next class, pakka. I don't promise pizza and all because I can't afford it. So samosa is well within my budget. Guys, anybody? Any progress? So guys, when you draw the diagram, you'll come to know about it. So the answer is hidden in the diagram itself. So there is a chord of contact. Let's say this is your chord of contact, okay? And this chord of contact subtends a right angle at the center. So this is your right angle, okay? So does it remind you of the concept of homogenization? Homogenization. So homogenization is basically a concept which says that the equation of the pair of straight lines from the origin to the point which is being formed by intersection of a line with a conic is obtained by homogenizing this line and this conic equation. What is the meaning of homogenization? Means making the degree of the entire equation uniformly as 2. So chord of contact, what is the equation of the chord of contact? We know chord of contact equation in this case is going to be this. Correct? Yes or no? I have to homogenize this equation with the equation of the ellipse. So I have to homogenize these two equations. Homogenize means By using these two equations, I have to uniformly create an equation of degree 2. So what I'm going to do is, in place of 1 over here, I'm going to write the square of this term. So please see carefully what I'm going to do. I'm going to write 1 as 1 square, and this 1 I'm going to replace it with xh by a square plus yk by b square whole square. Now you realize that it's a homogeneous second degree equation, okay, which actually represents the pair of straight lines OP and OQ, right? It represents the pair of straight lines OP and OQ together. So this concept I have repeated so many times in past also, and I'm yet repeating it. Now guys, okay, it's fine. It represents a second degree equation, and it represents a pair of straight lines OP and OQ. But how does this help us to solve this present question? Okay. Now, we all know that in any pair of straight lines, please know this concept very, very well. In any homogeneous equation like this, which represents a pair of straight lines, if the lines are perpendicular, a plus b has to be zero. That means the sum of the coefficient of x square and y square has to be zero. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to extract the coefficient of x square and y square from this huge equation, and I'm going to add them, and I'm going to make it zero. Right? So I'll be, handpicking these terms. Let's say coefficient of x square will be 1 by a square from here, and minus h square by a to the power 4 from here. Plus coefficient of y square is 1 by b square from here, and minus k square by b to the power 4 from here. This should be equal to 0. Which clearly brings me in one shot to my required result, that is h square by a to the power 4 plus k square by b to the power 4 is 1 by a square plus b square. Right? Hence proved. And when you talk about locus, locus of h comma k, okay, you can just replace your h, generalize it, replace your h with x and k with y. That gives you the locus of h comma k as well. So the locus of all those points from where the chord of contact drawn to this ellipse would subtend a right angle at the center is given by this equation. Okay. Do you realize that it itself is an ellipse with the same center as the center of the given ellipse? Is that clear, guys? Please type clear on the chat box if it is clear. So we'll move on to the next concept, that is the chord bisected at a given point. The next concept is the chord bisected at a given point. So guys, again, you'll start realizing that concepts are quite repetitive. The whatever you have learned in circles is getting repeated. Of course, with some minor changes in terms of their representation, but overall the structure is the same. So if you have a chord like this, okay, whose midpoint is x1, y1, then we say the equation of the chord whose midpoint is x1, y1 is given by t equal to s1. That is, x1 by a square, y1 by b square is equal to x1 square a square plus y1 square by b square. Okay.